Yeah, this looks like it's really going to happen.
Yeah.
Where were you this season when you had the easiest run in ever and yeah. still could have beat Man City?
One, two, three, Pep.
Yeah. Welcome back, guys, to a Q&A with myself and Nico because Paddy is away this week, which is a coincidence considering he needs to eat a considerable amount of hot sauce. That is going to be coming up probably not next week, but the week after.
Tell Paddy in the transfer, in the comment section. Remind
yes.
him. Yes.
Remind Paddy in the comment section that he has to eat a lot of hot sauce. But let's get around to the Q&A. Oh, I'm actually starting.
Well, then start maybe.
Adi Naik, I think is how you pronounce it. Can Barcelona afford both Griezmann and De Ligt in this transfer window?
Just by the name, do you think he prefers Adidas or Nike?
Oh.
Adi Naik?
Let us know. Adidas or Nike?
Can they afford Griezmann and De Ligt is the question. Mm. Well, they already afforded Frankie de Jong, so these guys are on a...
And they're both of them on top.
Yeah. Hard to say. On the other hand, Real is spending big money at the moment without selling somebody for big money.
Yeah, that's
true. Mean, they had the Ronaldo transfer, but there's like a third of what they spent by now. And so I wouldn't be surprised if they can. I mean, I would be surprised because I would have to ask, where is all the money coming from, guys?
Yeah.
But if they do it in the end, that wouldn't shock me.
No one would say a thing. We did speak about this, however, on yesterday's video about Matthijs de Ligt in general, so make sure you go and check that out. We'll leave a link in the comment section down below.
But I'm going.
We'll move on to you.
Next, and this is a question, well, it's from Pathikrit Josh. Great name. Is Origi the most underrated striker in world football?
Origi's a funny one. So I always thought he looked really good for Belgium. Remember when his 2014 World Cup? Looked really good for Belgium, a great up-and-coming prospect. Then went on loan, he was at Wolfsburg for a year. Was okay-ish. Didn't quite look like, I don't think he's up to the standard of Firmino or any of the top strikers in the league.
No.
But winning goals in the league against Newcastle and Everton, semi-final double against Barcelona, and a winning goal in the Champions League final. I don't think he's up there.
He's a great joker.
Yeah,
it's,
yeah.
It's lovely to have him
joker
on the bench.
Joker on the English means like wild card.
Oh, okay, yeah. I'm sorry. It's great to bring him in and super sub. That's
yeah,
what he is.
A super sub.
But like, he has never shown in the slightest that he can carry an offense as a striker.
He's not gonna turn up and get 25 goals a season. And unfortunately at Liverpool, he's not going to get a starting position either. Yeah. Right, Boyd Jeremiah says, from the current active players, who has the making of a good coach one day?
You have somebody on the top of your head? I have two German names I want to do.
You go with yours, I've got one.
Bastian Schweinsteiger first.
Yep.
He is a technical genius. He improved so much on a tactical level during his footballing career, starting as a winger, then becoming a number six, like playing basically as a deep anchor in midfield. Yeah. He learned football on a complete new level at the age of 25, which you can only do if you have a great understanding of the game,
that's difficult.
If you ask me. And then I have a wild card, the next Jurgen Klopp, Joshua Kimmich.
Kimmich also seems to be built from that Philipp Lahm kind of mold where you understand everything.
Yeah, but Kimmich on top is like this super motivational guy. He's like always always on 110%.
Future captain on Germany?
Yeah, he's got a captain both, Bayern and Germany, within not too long.
I'm going to go, only because I've heard it mentioned a lot, and now he's actually taken up a player managerial role, is Vincent Kompany.
Good call.
Is definitely. Yeah. Well, see how he does at Anderlecht.
Yeah.
I always wonder, do you just play yourself as a manager?
I mean, you're like, guys.
You look around, I'm going to have to save the day again.
I will have to play up front, guys. Yeah. There's no other striker in this team. I'll do it.
Yeah.
All right.
Fine, I'll do it. I often wondered that.
Amad Riaz, with the question for you, is Daniel James a good signing for United? Actually, this interests me a lot because I don't know shit about him.
Yeah. Is Daniel James a good signing? He is a good young player. Don't be mistaken in thinking he's the savior of Man United.
Yeah.
Those guys have deep-rooted problems and massive players in that changing room, all of whom are used to the pressure and should be carrying Man United to a higher level. To put that expectation on Daniel James would be a bit crazy. Is he a good player for the future? He looks it. Certainly a fantastic season at Swansea. But United fans can't have him there with any expectation. He's a kid.
It's such a big stage, Manchester United.
How old is he? I think 19.
All right.
Or 20. Mm-hmm. You can't, like, I mean, for 50 million, there's nothing these days. Come up from the Championship. Well, he had a good season. He looks a fantastic player. Very, very quick. Very direct. But yeah, to put him in the same class as any of the other attackers is a bit soon, maybe. But it's a step in the right direction for the future.
I got another one for you from
Kieran
Mitzen. Yeah, so how you say it?
Yeah, I think so.
What position has the least amount of quality talent available on the market currently?
Ooh, that's a really good question.
It used to be fullbacks. And then France just started to produce one brilliant fullback after the other.
I thought this, and wingers and wingbacks became such a vital part of the game. I think there's lots. The one I will say, and it's an obvious one, is goalkeeper. Because there's obviously far fewer goalkeepers than there are outfielders. And all the top clubs have a keeper. Mm-hmm. So you know that the best keepers in the world are already at a top club. And if you're a top club without one, who are you gonna sign? For example, Barca or Real or whoever don't have the keeper. So De Stegen's not there, or let's say De Gea's not United or Kepa.
I'd go for Donnarumma, but he's gonna be expensive. Cheaper option would be the Polish kid, Dongowski.
Yeah, but he's not a top goalkeeper.
Well,
he had elite level.
He had a few top performances, 21. What do you expect? Or 22? I would disagree. I would actually say centre backs. I feel like there will be a lack of centre backs in the next few years.
Yeah.
Because centre backs, like, it brings. You have to have that certain height already, which already, there's less people that have that size in general.
Yeah, that's true.
Then you have that to be combined with great understanding, great talent. So I would say that the centre-back.
Do you think that of all positions, the centre-back is in the most transitional phase? Because we're getting rid of all the old centre-backs who were just big lumps.
Yeah, yeah.
And we're bringing in the new football-playing, intelligent passing centre-backs.
I just had an idea, by the way.
Who?
Tell me five classic strikers, young talents. There are none.
Jan Vita Arp.
he's been dog shit.
Okay.
Jovic, Pietro Pellegri from Monaco. They are not too many. Cutrone, maybe.
Sorry. Took a big intake of breath there.
Metz Stein.
You could probably go back and watch that just in slow motion.
He's dying just like the classic striker position.
Just like the classic. Again, strikers going through a bit of a transition.
Yeah.
There's not so many sort of big Jan Koller-esque strikers anymore.
Peter Crouch.
There's probably one or two. But I think there are always going to be attackers. Kids growing up are always going to want to be
attackers.
They
want to score goals.
They want to score goals. Defenders is a good call. Right, moving on. Which means the end of my coughing. From Vasista D. So we've got a quick fire here.
Vasista D.
How likely are these transfers will happen on a scale of 1 to 5? So 1 being not going to happen, 5 going to happen. Kai Havertz to Bayern.
1.
It's not happening.
Not this summer.
No.
Maybe next summer. Not this summer.
Tanguy Ndombele to Spurs.
I could see that. From what I heard there in talks, 3.
Huh? I would have given that 4, but whatever.
All right.
Maguire to Man City.
Whew. You tell me.
I think 2.
Did
more
talk
likely
about
to unite.
Yeah. Like that?
The only reason because he's English.
Yeah.
That's the and obviously teams need a certain quota of English players. Rabiot to Man United.
That's something I called a few months ago.
Oh, really?
I said they should go all in for Rabiot. I'd give that a 3.
Complete upgrade on Matic.
Yeah.
And James to Napoli.
4.5.
This looks a go.
Nobody else wants it.
Yeah, this looks like it's really going to happen.
Yeah. No, that's a 4.5. All right. Amir Fais with the question, who should Spurs sacrifice between Kane and Dele Alli to fund their rebuild for the current squad? Both don't seem to fit Pochettino's current tactics.
Ay-ay-ay.
That's going to make you mad.
That's a lie that they don't fit the current tactics. I mean, both of them have been an integral part to Pochettino taking Spurs from Europa League to a Champions League
Absolutely.
Final. So yeah, to say they're not part of the tactics, this whole thing, Ali's had a poor season, understandably. A lot of players have poor seasons.
Harry Kane was injured.
And Harry Kane was injured, and this whole myth about Spurs being better when he's injured is a lie. Spurs had a shocking end to the season without him. Yes, he came back and he wasn't 100% fit. Harry Kane's the best striker Spurs have, probably the best striker England have. You're not gonna be better off by selling him.
No.
Dele Alli is a fantastic attacking midfielder.
If you had to sell one of them.
If I had to sell one, it would be Alli. Yeah. I think you can find another good attacking midfielder. Harry Kane is certainly for Spurs, and the fact he came through the youth academy is a once in a lifetime.
On the other hand,
I wouldn't sacrifice either. Christian Eriksen, I'd sacrifice.
Yeah, he can go.
Yeah.
On the other hand, I feel like, man, with Harry Kane, he's one injury away from saying maybe.
Yeah. Don't get me wrong. I think Kane's longevity has probably taken a massive hit in his career. Mm-hmm. I don't think past 30 he'll be anything like he was. Let's not forget Kane is currently 25 years old.
Yeah, I know, it's crazy.
A lot of football to play. He's still young.
And he's a one-season wonder.
He's a one-season wonder, apparently. He scored a hatful of goals, even with all these injuries. And yeah, to say that he doesn't fit in the tactics. I mean, this whole Pochettino regime, the tactics have been built around how good Ali and Kane are.
Yeah.
It's bizarre to think otherwise. Anyway, moving on. I hate everyone. I don't know if that's a statement or a YouTube name, but
thank you.
From I hate everyone, where should Ziyech go? Hakim Ziyech.
I thought Frankfurt. No, it's not going to happen.
Where could? Let's just say should.
I would love to see what Juventus.
Oh yeah. Oh, he'd be really good.
Because right?
Douglas Costa's really...
No.
There's
no,
always
no, no.
something surrounding him.
Yeah, there's something weird with Douglas Costa. Yeah. Always been.
Like, and he's always late to training, I've read.
That's whatever he wants. He has like this classic 90s Brazilian approach to the game. Like, yeah, I love the game, but yeah, I might stay in Brazil for another 4 weeks in the winter.
Yeah.
I can't really tell yet if I'm going to be there. I would just say Juventus because I just want to see Juventus. Juventus needs some fresh blood, some fresh legs in the squad. And I could see him fit in there very well. So I would go with you.
That's pretty good.
Okay, we got Shukla Shaka. Is it fair for Liverpool facing big teams on the 36th and 37th match day? And this again is going to make you mad, I think.
Oh God, I saw this earlier and I saw there was a few people in the comments saying UEFA, the Premier League have rigged it against Liverpool. Oh, do me a favour. Every team has to play every team. Whether it's funny that these Liverpool fans who said, oh, we've got to play, 36th and 37th game are difficult, but didn't hear you this season.
Where they're the easiest.
Where
schedule.
Were you this season when you had the easiest run in ever and still couldn't beat Man City? Where were you this year? Absolutely nowhere. And secondary, so there's two flip sides to it. So either you play all the hard teams first and get them out of the way, giving you an easier run in, which Liverpool had last season, or you play the easier, it's quite offensive to the rest of them, but outside the top six, we'll call them, easier teams first. So by the time that 36th and 37th match day come around, you might be 10 points clear already.
Yeah.
These games might mean nothing because you've played all the other teams earlier.
Absolutely.
So it's completely, look, the fixtures are obviously very exciting. Don't get me wrong, I'm hyped and Spurs have got City and Arsenal away in the first month.
Yeah, exactly.
Aston Villa at home, not too bad. But you get them out of the way, you get a good point there, it sets you up for the rest of the season. It's just... Where were these Liverpool fans on the easy run-in?
Would you play top six teams on the first six match days in the season?
Yeah,
you would, right?
You would. Yeah. You'd get them out of the way and build some momentum. If you build momentum for the whole season, then lost it at the crunch point, which Spurs very oftenly do.
But on the other hand, if you lose the first six games...
You're miles behind. Yeah, but you still got a chance to make it up.
Yeah, that is right.
Yeah, that is facing big teams at the end.
Yeah.
Anyway. Next up, Crooked TV. That's so good, they named him twice. Who would you rather have as a coach? Ooh, Pep Guardiola or Jurgen Klopp?
As our personal coach or as
Let's say you're a player.
We're not talking about my club. We're not talking about Frankfurt and Tottenham. We're talking about I'm a player, it doesn't matter where.
That's how we'll interpret it.
Okay, on three, we'll say it both.
Okay.
Klopp or Pep, so it's nice and short.
Okay.
One, two, three, Pep.
Yeah! I thought you were going to say Klopp because the German thing.
No.
Don't get me wrong, working under Klopp would also be amazing. Yeah.
But I think Guardiola is just such a football brain.
I think from tactically, I'd be fascinated to talk to Guardiola about football. Whereas Klopp would motivate you in crazy amounts. I just feel like Guardiola would be more interesting.
If you ask me who I'd rather drink a beer with, I'd go for Klopp.
Yeah.
It's not a question.
I'd rather sit down and talk to Guardiola, but I'd rather be around Klopp. I think his energy and his vibe. Yeah,
he's one of these guys. Like he drags you. You know.
Yeah.
All right. The man, has Carrasco signed with Arsenal? And if yes, how good can he be? In your idea.
He hasn't signed yet. There's a lot of rumours. It does look like if he's heading back from China to European football, that will be with Arsenal, a fantastic signing, is how I think.
Yeah.
Very odd that he decided to move at the age of 24 to China, but it's a brilliant player nonetheless. He's still in the Belgian national team.
He's smart, man. He made big coin for like 1.5 years
He made big money
back.
And he's, fair enough. He's still in the Belgian squad. He's an unbelievable player. Definitely what Arsenal need. Definitely a big step up on the likes of Iwobi and Mkhitaryan. I think he'd be a fantastic signing for Arsenal. Next up from Barish Chaturbedi, who said, who should Bayern Munich sign to regain their European dominance?
Get Leroy Sané in, first and foremost, if you can pull it off somehow, do it. Bayern has already spent quite some money on the defense.
I was going to say, they've got a lot of players in already.
Defense is more or less done, but if I was Bayern, I would bring in at least one more winger. Actually, two would be better because Gnabry and Coman both were very injury prone. So Sané, I would actually say Bayern should try to sign Carrasco because compared to what you get, he's one of the cheapest players on the market, I'd say, and a backup striker.
Oh yeah, a backup striker. Backup.
Because
Timo Werner, not happening.
Yeah, it's difficult. I always say, and I don't want it to happen, but I still say Sebastian Allaire because he gives another dimension to the game. He's a classic target man, not a classic, not the poacher that Lewandowski is sometimes.
Plan B.
Yeah, exactly. He gives the offense a different dimension. If Lewandowski doesn't work, which he, quite frankly, hasn't in the big games recently, you can try something else. All right. Ozabe Progress, what is your favorite player ever, Matt?
Ever? Wow, this is a discussion. Favorite or I think it's the best? I mean, growing up as a kid in England, it's David Beckham, one of my favorite ever. I mean, Teddy Sheringham was my hero at Tottenham with David Ginola.
Yeah, fair.
I'd say my favorite to watch ever from the whole perspective, and I saw him live once, was Zinedine Zidane.
Really?
Zidane was just... It was like mesmerizing that he could move.
Yeah.
And with the ball.
Have you ever seen that 90 minutes camera only on Zidane thing?
Yeah.
That's insane.
I studied that at college.
Yeah, it's insane.
We had to study it for some work, yeah.
It's insane.
I'd say my favorite player ever is probably Zinedine Zidane. What about you?
I don't really have a favorite all-time player.
This is too many.
There's so many great ones. Just
for
like
so many reasons.
Even as a German,
well.
I love David Beckham. I love everything about him. I love the Ronaldo, the real Ronaldo, the old Ronaldo.
Oh my
I
God,
loved
yeah.
him, I adored him. I frightened people in Inzaghi. I was afraid of him, like actually scared of Inzaghi. I loved Gattuso's energy. So even of the players that are not considered like all-time legends like Gattuso and Inzaghi, I love them too.
There's too many categories.
Yeah.
But let us know yours, please, in the comment section below. Or for whatever reason, it can be any reason you like, your most favorite player ever.
Schweinsteiger top five all time for me.
Really?
Yeah, I just love them.
Good player. Oh. Next up from RSS Gallot, who says, is Inter Milan the best destination for Lukaku?
Well, the question is, what is the best destination? It means, I think Icardi is going to leave. That would have to happen for Lukaku to go there. That would also mean they're going to try to build a team around him and Lautaro Martinez.
Yeah.
And I like that idea. I like Lukaku in the Serie A. I think that could be fun to see, even though Serie A has some under-the-radar great and physical defenses in that league. But for me at the moment it is, but just because I would love to see him there.
He did say as well that he thinks Conte is the best manager in the world.
And that he loves Italy, and that he likes Inter Milan.
He's looking for a move.
Definitely.
Do you remember when he moved and Pogba was so hyped that he went to Man United?
Yeah.
They were loving it.
They were like best friends, but they're not anymore, I think, right?
I feel like they both realized they need to move on. They're cutting ties early.
They do. Okay, I got a quick fire for you.
Yes.
Who will finish in which position next season in their leagues?
Wow.
Real Madrid.
Second.
That's what I said. Liverpool.
Second.
That's what I said. AC Milan. Milan.
Ooh. Napoli, Inter. I'm going to go fifth.
Oh, fifth. Who else was in there?
Who would I put in fourth? I'm going to go for Roma.
Ah, okay. I said fourth because I'm doing it secretly under my hands. Borussia Dortmund.
Second.
Easy money. Manchester City.
First.
Arsenal.
Ooh, Arsenal's a tough one. They could have a good summer. I think Chelsea may slip. I'm going for City, Liverpool, Tottenham in the top three. So maybe fourth. Yeah, Arsenal fourth.
Yeah, that's what I said. Yeah. Nice, I like it.
Right, to finish off with, from Arif Siddiqui, who said, how much can I buy Nico's marvelous beard for? I'm ready to pay Neymar's transfer fee. It's better than his career.
I just shaved it. It's quite short these days. So is yours, freshly shaved.
Yeah, yeah. Nice. You could sell this to Arib.
I'm not selling it.
And just grow another one.
Yeah, but I'm not doing it. I got it. Because that would mean I have to shave it at some point. And I'm afraid of my face. I haven't seen it.
I haven't seen my chin in years.
I haven't seen it in literally like 5 years. So, I don't want to
do that. Fun fact, Nico did shave his head on one of his very first videos on the German channel.
That is true. That is true. On my Instagram, there's one picture with like a shaved head.
About 2 years ago. Amazing. Anyway, great question to end on. And thank you for all of your questions in the Q&A. As mentioned before, leave all your thoughts and comment down below. Let Paddy know he has to eat the hot sauce. Mm-hmm. Who is your favorite ever player? there and all the rest of the topics that we've discussed.
Actually, follow Paddy on Twitter and tell him there.
Oh yeah, at Paddy Higgs.
Yeah, I think so.
Let's get him, we'll leave it down there too. Anyway, thanks for tuning in guys and we'll see you again next time.